What's up, y'all? As y'all can see, a lot has changed because I got on the headset, and y'all know how I felt about headsets, right? But anyway, I know it's been a minute. A lot has changed, a lot going on. Everybody hitting me up, asking me if we, how we doing. So I guess I'm gonna give y'all an update somewhere in here. But y'all, a lot has changed because look what the hell I have. And y'all know I do not like pulling domestic trailers at all. But we're gonna get more into all of that. Anyway, y'all wanna see Big Mama? There's no Big Mama. But right now I just parked for the day. I am in Ohio, y'all. Ohio. Yes, I'm in Ohio. I just parked for the night and I'm about to go in this Pilot and get something for my airlines because the thing that I had holding my airlines together. How y'all doing? Yes, I look a hot mess because I'm on a load and yeah, but anyway, the thing that I had holding my airlines together, it popped. So I'm about to go in here and get something to put my airlines up so that they don't just be hanging and dangling and doing all of that stuff. But I'm gonna come back to y'all with an update so y'all can figure out, or y'all can know, what the hell is going on. Why am I in Ohio? Why am I pulling a domestic trailer? And why the hell am I headed to Texas? And y'all know I hate Texas, but I'm gonna be right back with y'all. I wonder how many of y'all have been watching me for a long time to remember when I had one of these little fifth wheel thing and I lost it and I never bought another one. Well, guess what? I never need it. Like, I never even need it. It's so easy for me to pull my fifth wheel. That's hilarious. Yo, this bump is so disrespectful, but whatever. Anyway, so of course Pilot didn't have what I wanted because y'all, I hate Pilot. But I got something that I'm gonna make work until I can get what I want, just so that my airlines aren't like this. Yeah, they keep falling because I had them kind of strapped up here, and the strap that I had on there, it broke. So I'm about to braid them back up, and this time I'm gonna put some zip ties on them so they can stop coming loose, and see how that works out. Hey y'all, y'all see what I'm putting, but anyway, yeah, let me go do that. So now y'all can see what I did. It's not ideal. Again, this is just temporary until I can, I don't know if y'all can see that. Y'all see how those wraps are? I'm gonna wrap them up like that, but Pilot didn't have nothing in there like that. So I had to do what I had to do to just get them off of my catwalk. And I use this because this is stretchy and obviously it's got to be able to stretch. I put the zip ties on it so they can stop, you know, falling apart. But it'll work until I can get to, a better solution. Yeah, basically. I'm just trying to not have it land on the car wash. On the catwalk. The reason why I said car wash is because, yes, I know Big Mama is dirty and she needs a bath, but the load that I just ran, it was muddy out there, and this is the end result of it. So, yeah. Oh, well. Anyway, off to get some food.
Y'all, yeah, I absolutely hate the Pilot. I hate the Pilot. That's all I want to say is that I hate the Pilot. I know I'm like crazy. I definitely hate the Pilot, and the reason why I hate the Pilot is because it's just so ghetto. It's so ghetto. I just got into the shower, And y'all, I just hate pilots. This shit, I really, really hate pilots.
Good morning, y'all. It's the next day, as you can see. I ate last night, took my little Tylenol PM, and that was a wrap. I was obviously tired, so once I get tired, hold on, y'all. I'm trying to figure out a way I could put my phone. No, is that gonna work? No, that's not gonna work. Maybe it'll work. No, it won't work. Anyway, I'll sit y'all right there then. How about that? I'm about to get up and head out. Y'all. I'm still a little tired, but I'm okay though. About to drink Red Bull. Because I don't want to leave out too late. Because then that means I'll be stopping late. And then parking will be like weird or whatever. So, just getting up. I'm about to do a pre-trip on my... Well, I just brushed my teeth and everything. But I'm about to wash my face. I'm about to wash my face. I use these little rose water wipes when I be on prep for washing my face. I do a face cleanser in the evening when I'm in the shower, but when I wake up in the morning on my prep, this is what I use. I am in East Palestine, Texas. I'm lying, y'all. Don't pay me no attention. I'm still tired. I'm in East Palestine, Ohio, y'all. And I'm going to Texas. I'm going to Houston. And, yeah. It's supposed to be 20 hours from here. I'm supposed to... Originally, I was supposed to offload tomorrow, which would be Sunday. So I was gonna drive all day today, all day tomorrow to make it there. Well, I just checked my message, my inbox on the new Hennef app for the drivers who know the new Hennef app. I checked my inbox and I see that they updated the delivery date to Tuesday. So I don't know what that's all about. I'm gonna wait till my terminal manager, until I like know that he's up or whatever, and then I'm gonna call him and find out what's going on with that, because yeah, I already got a slide back by the house. So if this load is not delivering until Tuesday, I'll be going through New Orleans tomorrow, and I'm gonna shut that down in New Orleans tomorrow if it's possible for me to do so. But anyway, let me stop rambling. Let me go do my pre-trip and I'm gonna come back to y'all, okay? Yeah, so I did my pre-trip, did all that good stuff, and I thought we was about to roll out, but I am following, it's like three or four of us that are going down there, and I'm following one of the other drivers. And he called me and woke me up at 6 to ask me if I was ready to go. And I was like, nah, man, I need another hour or two, right? But then I ended up getting up at 6:30, and I called him and he was already up. So he's like, all right. I'm like, all right, we can go ahead and get ready to roll out. So I'm thinking he already done did everything he needs to do. So I'm trying to rush, get myself together. I did my pre-trip, started my clock, and then I called him. I'm like, we can roll. Let's go somebody get something to eat.
Yeah, so like I was saying, I was thinking he was ready to go. And he was like, driver, you don't eat no breakfast or nothing? Like, no, I just get my little drink and I roll. But anyway, so that's why I was in McDonald's. I just went ahead and got me a little hash brown or whatever. And y'all want to know something that's so funny? People always ask me how do I ride. And I feel like they just assume that I make a lot of stops, that I do this, that I do that. Baby, we can run a full 6-7. Then I'm gonna need to stop and take a 30. And then we can run the rest. Like, and really the only reason, like I told him, I said, I gotta stop because I'll be having to go to the bathroom. And I can't pee in the bottle like the rest of y'all drivers can. Y'all men drivers can. But anyway, we about to hit this road and I'm gonna come back to y'all whenever we do stop.
So I am back. Just drove through a hole. Freaking storm, like real live storm coming through Cincinnati, and we just stopped or whatever, and we are obviously, you know, you want to check your load and everything. Well, y'all check this out. This is why it's important to check. No, wait. Placard, them blew off. The shit blew off in the fucking storm. So I'm about to replace this placard. And since I done stopped, I'm about to go ahead and put my placard covers on. Word of advice, make sure you put your placard protectors on, because if it rains and the placards get wet, it is very, very hard to try to put a placard protector over it if it's too wet because they start to rip. Always remember to get extra placards. I had extra placards. The shipper gave me 4 extra placards, so I actually put on the one that was missing and I replaced 2 of them because it was too wet. I couldn't put the protectors on them, but y'all know I'm used to pulling ISOs. We have stick-on placards, so yeah, basically I had forgot to put those placard protectors on. And if you don't have no placard protectors, you need to get some. I had mine for the longest. So anyway, about to hop back on this road. I'm gonna try to make it down to Birmingham as far as I can. I don't know how far I'm gonna get, but I'll come back to y'all. Y'all, I was gonna come on here and complain, but before I do that, all I can say is thank God for traveling grace. You know, we as truck drivers, we really risk a lot to be out here in these trucks doing what we do, pulling what we pull amongst the commoners. But with that being said, y'all, let's start off by saying that I drove 615 miles today. However, I did not get as far as I wanted to get. I'm about, I'm in Columbia. Where am I? Columbia, Tennessee, I think. I could be wrong. Don't quote me on that, y'all. My hand is hurting. I'm in Columbia, Tennessee, I do believe. I was trying to make it to Birmingham, Alabama. Couldn't do it. I'm about 160 miles away from Birmingham, Alabama, and I only had 30 minutes left on my clock, so I had to stop. Like, I couldn't go no further. Y'all, I have been driving through storm after storm after storm after storm ever since I left out of Cincinnati. Storming with a combination of people who don't know how to drive. Hear me out, y'all. Hear me out. Truck driver, I don't care if you're a truck driver, I don't care if you're a regular driver. If you are uncomfortable with driving in the rain, park. It's simple. It's really simple. If you're uncomfortable with driving in the rain, park. Because people like me who are comfortable with driving in the rain, all you doing is holding us up. That's all you doing. Or at least stay in the right lane. I drove through storm after storm after storm and had to deal with stupid people who did not know how to drive in the rain. So with that being said, I did 615 miles today. I'm parked. I'm about to go get me something to eat. My head is banging really, really, really bad. So obviously it is 6:42 and this truck stop is packed. They had nowhere to park. However, y'all know me, I'm good for making me a parking spot. Anyway, I don't park in the aisles, in the lanes. I never do. Even it can be completely empty and I'm still not gonna park in the aisles or the lanes, because I don't want nobody backing in on the sides of me. Like, I'm paranoid about people backing in on the side of me. So with that being said, yeah, I just made me a parking spot. I look a hot mess because I'm tired. But I'm gonna go run in here and get me some food, and I'm gonna come back to y'all with that update. Y'all remember last night when I said that I do not like pilots because pilots be so ghetto? Well, since I've been up north, I've stopped at Three Loves, and I don't know what's going on with y'all loves up here up north. Well, I don't even know what this is right here, but in Tennessee, or what you want to consider this to be. But these loves are not loving. They're not. Like, I've never had to stand in line to use the restroom at a Love's. And every single Love that I have stopped at today, I've had to stand in line. On top of the fact, I just went into Arby's. Yeah, I know, whatever. Say what y'all want to say about Arby's. But it smelled so bad. It smelled horrible. But let me tell you, it wasn't Arby's fault that it smelled bad in there. It was them drivers' fault. Y'all, it's storming outside. Like, I'm talking about full-blown storming. I had to pull out the raincoat, do all of that. They got drivers in there wet, soaking wet, and they smell horrible. Like, dog, why you just didn't go take a shower first before you come in here to eat? Because why do you smell like that? Got the whole Arby's funky. It's funky. It's real, real, real funky. But anyway, let me take my medicine because my back hurts very much so, and eat and calm my nerves. Okay, so I decided to try that new, how you say, a Wagyu burger. I'm gonna let y'all know how it is. Y'all know I love a good burger. Hey y'all, hey. It is Sunday. Say hey to Big Mama. It's Sunday, and I know y'all probably looking like, what is going on? Well, my load was supposed to deliver today, well, this evening at 7 o'clock. They pushed the load back to 5 or 7 o'clock on Tuesday. I don't know, one of the times. And the route that I was taking, I decided to come home. Yes, I just had to come home. Why? Because why am I going to go and sit in Houston for 2 days when I can come home? I already been gone away from home since Thursday. So, yeah, I just decided to come home. Still getting paid for it. That's the good part about it. And for all of the negative Nancys that like to watch my videos and pick them apart and go holler at Leon and them, obviously the tank is stored and secured at our facility. So no, I did not leave the trailer nowhere. I didn't leave the trailer on the street. I didn't leave the trailer at a truck stop or nothing like that, because those that don't know, you are not supposed to leave a placard trailer unattended. Or you get what I'm saying, like, you can't just leave no placard trailer in the truck stop, or leave it, park it, drop it somewhere, and then go on about your business. Even though I see it all the time, not me, not doing it. But anyway, I just wanted to say that because them people, y'all know them people, they like to watch my videos sometimes. Don't judge my bonnet, y'all. I just drove 7.5 hours straight. My eye is irritated, clearly. And it was raining still, so My bonnet was on, my hood is on. Yeah. So, since this vlog is still rolling, I'm about to go home, grab my babies. I'm about to go take a shower and get dressed. And then I guess y'all about to see what mommy life is kind of like since y'all are part of this vlog. And I'll come back to y'all. Find number. Oh, there she go. Over there, there go Leah. Talia, Leo. They got a long way to go. Follow it
down.
Look, say hi to the vlog.
You're not vlogging.
I'm literally
vlogging. Vlogging what?
Why?
For why?
Say hi.
No, I don't want to say hi to nobody.
Don't want to say hi, whatever. Y'all know how these kids. Wait for the baby to go. Go, Arisa. She ain't doing it. She only did one. Go, Chloe. Oh, she trying to flex on you, Chloe. Go again, Chloe. Wait for the babies to go. She did it back and the front. Go, Chloe. Go, hurry up.
I had to think what I was going to do.
You gotta think? Okay, wait for the babies to go first. All right, go.
Mommy.
I keep straining, so y'all don't think I ain't washed my face or something like that. My eye has been irritated for some reason, and I washed my eye a few times. I keep putting drops in it. I don't know. It's still irritating. It's straining. Anyway, it's Monday. It's late in the afternoon. It's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. I didn't do anything today except for clean up around the house, do some laundry, and been laying down because all of a sudden I had a toothache. Like, that's why my hair looked like this. I had my bonnet on all day. I had my bonnet on all day, and I only just took it off. I don't even know why I just took it off, because all I'm doing is dropping them off. And I just took it off to drop them off, but I didn't have to get out of the car, as y'all can see. So that's why I look like this. Y'all be wanting the real unfiltered, uncensored stuff. Well, this is real unfiltered, uncensored, whatever you want to call it. But I'm also about to go drop some stuff off at the Goodwill that's been sitting in my hallway for a couple of days now. Y'all, I yelled at them kids so bad earlier. Y'all ever yell at y'all kids and then y'all feel bad about it? Yeah, that's what happened. Because I told them to clean up their room and I dozed off. Like I said, I got a toothache. I was laying down, so I end up dozing off. And I wake up to my dog barking. Like, my dog is barking. She wants to go outside. Okay. Well, I'm thinking to myself, like, where the hell is all these kids at? Well, I wake up, everybody in the swimming pool. Everybody in the pool. Everybody in the pool. Okay. Get up, go look at their room. Their room looked worse than what the heck it looked when I told them to clean it up. So y'all know I could have bad, real bad. About to drop this stuff off at the Goodwill, and I hope they got somebody right here, because I ain't about to get this stuff out. Oh, they do. Good morning. Today is Tuesday. It's Tuesday. Don't laugh at my face, y'all. I got Vaseline on my face because my face was hella dry. I just dropped the brats off at camp, and I am headed to Big Mama so we can roll out. Headed to Texas. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to flip this. Depending on how traffic and everything is, I might be able to. But if not, I'm going to just shut it down. Depending on how I feel. Either way it goes, don't really matter. Because I went ahead and did my 34 so I can get my full clock back. So when I do make it back, I could be ready to work. Because had I not done a 34, and if I would have left out yesterday, when I would have came back, I would have only had about 6 hours left on my clock, so I didn't want that. But yeah, I'm headed to the yard and I'll come back to y'all.
Your boy George Boyle was giving conflicting information.
Say hi to the vlog, Damon. You told me to vlog, so I've been vlogging this whole thing. Say hi, Damon. I didn't film you, but now you on the vlog. So
did you already deliver yours?
Depot.
No, she gonna do it now.
Terminal manager. Hell of a
put the time
combination.
For 10, sent it to her truck, and then changed it back to 5 and sent it to
y'all. So I had to pull over and stop because as I'm driving, coming through Baton Rouge, coming over the bridge, all of these lights popped up on Big Mama. Y'all, Big Mama is sensitive, okay? She's very sensitive. The lights popped up. I wanted to stop and pull over to check and make sure everything was okay before I hit the Atchafalaya, because if you're from down here, you know you don't want to be broke down on the Atchafalaya. So I stopped in Port Allen and I waited for my friend to pull up. He's about to come check it. He said it could just be a sensor. The truck doesn't feel like it's driving any different. It doesn't feel like something's wrong. I got out and I checked everything, but I don't hear nothing. I don't see nothing. And So, yeah, he's going to come up over here and just check it for me. He said it could just be a sensor. So, I don't know. But we going to see. These are the lights. That's the trailer traction, trailer ABS. Obviously, I'm parked. My truck ABS light and my truck's traction control. So, all four of those lights are on. So, we going to see what he say. This is the type of stuff that scares me, y'all. So, I was parked all the way up there even with this other truck. Y'all see where that truck is? Buddy was literally trying to back in to this spot over there. He's trying to back into that spot over there. As y'all can see, Swift over there or whatever. I was parked all the way up there and he really was trying to back up to, I'm talking about to the left side of Swift, not to the right, to the left side of Swift. And I'm like, oh nah, let me back up. So when I get on my truck, he looking at me, asked me if I'm trying to help him back. I said nah, I'm about to back my truck up, like I'm about to get out your way. Yeah, like no, you're making me nervous, sir. So I guess he gonna try it again. Let's go see what little cute. Even though he's supposed to be big king, but really I'm king. What you doing? Oh, I didn't know you had somebody with you. Say hi. Don't do that. If y'all are ever in VR or Fort Allen, whatever, I am at S&M Tires. It's a black owned, basically semi tires, diesel mechanic, all that type of stuff over here. So I came over here for this guy to hook this up. Hopefully he fixed my truck.
Are you the size of something? What you doing?
Where to come find you. I don't know why he's looking at me like that. I guess he hot. It's always something, y'all. So basically it's the sensors, and I'm gonna have to bring it to Peterbilt to get new sensors put on, but he said ain't nothing wrong with my truck mechanically, so we about to ride. Y'all, this is a very eventful vlog, because it's been a day, bro. So I'm riding on my way to Houston, and then I'm reaching for my eye drops because y'all know my eyes been irritated or whatever, and I'm like, where is my purse, y'all? Why did I left my purse at home? Good thing is I still have everything that I need as far as like ID and all of that shit as well. But my debit cards and all of that stuff at the house. Thank God for Tap. Thank God for Apple Pay, because I left them all at the house. So, yeah. Look at my eye. Y'all tired of my eye? We got a very dusty yard. And anytime dust gets in my eyes get irritated, and that's what happens. So they be irritated for a couple of days. Y'all should know this. Anyway, Tyler made it to the receiver, and they are holding all trucks. Yes, they are holding all trucks. I don't know what's going on, but they holding all of us right now. So I'm behind technically three other trucks. And I'm just sitting here waiting to see what the hell is going on. But I'll come back to y'all once again. So y'all, I'm finally getting offloaded. Well, I'm in line to get offloaded. Remember how I said there was two trucks ahead of me? Well, actually there was 6 or 7 trucks ahead of me, and they just have us, they let us come into the plant, and they just have us all back here lined up. So sometimes it gets a little crazy. When I loaded this, that was the fastest load time I've ever had. They took all of 10 minutes to load my truck. Like, I was literally in and out of the location in about 15 minutes in, out, like full tank loaded, 43,000 pounds loaded. But here we are. So it is now 7:30. I've been here since 5:15, and they have one truck waiting in front of me to get pulled under a rack. And I'm recording this because people always ask me, like, how long does it take to load y'all? How long does it take to unload? You never really know until you get to the facility and see how their process is. There's no two facilities that's alike. Well, sometimes there is, but what I'm saying is, until you get used to that facility's process, you'll never know how it really is. Because I've had coworkers that came here and it was like, oh, they fast, they take 20 minutes. You'll be in and out. I've been here, so we gonna see how much longer I gotta sit here and wait. Morning, y'all. It is Wednesday. It's a little windy out here, so hopefully y'all can hear me. It's Wednesday. I'm at the Pasadena terminal, and y'all that's been watching me for a while, y'all know that this is where I actually came and did my orientation at over 2 years ago. And so much has changed at this terminal since I've been out here. Well, I probably came out here 2 times after that, but even still, I haven't been out here in a while. And yeah, this shit crazy. They expanded everything. They expanded the yard. They expanded everything they got going on out here. Morning. They expanded everything, and yeah. It look real nice out here, but I'm about to get ready to hit this road and head back home, because y'all know I'm over it. Over it. Hey, y'all. I am back. Back. I made it to Geismar. I dropped a trailer at the tank wash. And now I am sitting on the yard because I'm waiting for my friend to pull up. She also runs for Hennef. She on a load right now, but she about to drop that and pull up. So I'm sitting here waiting on her. But y'all, Big Mama, it's so funny that I decided to vlog this week, and all of a sudden I'm having all of these issues or whatever, because honestly I haven't had no issues out of Big Mama. Like, I haven't had no issues out of Big Mama. So basically yesterday when I stopped, Lil Q told me that it was the sensors. Like, he hooked it up to the computer, it was the sensors, there was nothing mechanically wrong with my truck or with my trailer, it was the sensors. So y'all know my truck is still relatively new. It's gonna be a year that I've had it, August the 3rd or the 5th, somewhere in there. But anyway, so I called Peterbilt this morning, and they basically told me that the sensors are out of warranty. They are literally two weeks past warranty. So I was asked how many miles I had on my truck and everything like that, but basically they say that sensors are like a wear and tear type ordeal. But y'all, my truck just hit 26,000 miles. So I put 26,000 miles on my truck in a year. And the lights that are on are still the same lights, right? So I'm like, okay, like, but they can't even tell me how much the parts are. They said I have to bring my truck in, get a diagnostic, which at minimum is $170. and let them figure out which sensors are which, even though Q told me yesterday, like, he put it on a computer and he was able to tell me. So I don't know what I'm gonna do about it. I'm gonna figure it out. But I was hoping that once I drop my trailer that maybe, you know, maybe something would click and it would be good. But only one light went off. The only light that went off was the trailer ABS light. That's the only light that went off. So my truck ABS, my truck traction control, and the trailer cruise control, which I'm not even hooked to a trailer right now, but the trailer traction control is all, those lights are still on. And something else that is happening, is that on my dashboard I have a little circle that shows which gear you're in when you're driving, and for some reason the numbers are not showing up in that circle. It's just a straight up dash, a line, it's a line through it. Also, when I tried to drop my suspension when I was dropping the trailer, it came up on a dash saying that I cannot drop my suspension to please reduce speed. So that's all the things that my truck is doing right now. And I spoke to someone earlier and basically they asked me, did I come through a lot of rain? And I'm like, yes, like, y'all know I came through hella rain. Well, basically they're saying that something just got wet, like something just got too wet with me driving in 2 days worth of rain, and that something is not connecting, or it's still a possibility that the sensors did go completely out, but there's also a possibility that it's just not connecting or whatever. So I don't know. Peterbilt said they can't get to my truck to mid next week, but in my mind I'm thinking that I'm gonna go drop my truck off in the morning and hope that they can squeeze it in and figure out what's going on with it, because I don't know what's going on with it, but we're gonna find out anyway. Like I said, I'm sitting here waiting on my friend. Hopefully she about to pull up and then I'm about to head back to the city and we will officially be off this load. I feel like it's a whole week later, but, well, technically it is, but yeah, we'll officially be off this load. Y'all, so if you made it through this long week vlog, I finally made it back to the yard, parked. That load is capiche done. It's the first time I ever did a long haul load on, sorry, my brain just went, but anyway, that's the first time that I ever did a long haul load by myself, as well as in Big Mama. So if you made it through this video and you stuck around and hung around for the whole week with me, I definitely appreciate it. And as I was thinking, like, oh, I have to close the vlog out, I realized that I kept talking about giving y'all an update. So I'm just gonna take a few minutes to answer a couple of questions, a simple update, just to go over what is going on, what has been going on, what all that. Okay, so first things first, obviously y'all seen me do a long haul load. This is the first time that I've ever done a long haul load, but I decided to take the long haul because of two reasons. One, it's the summertime, my kids are not in school, so I'm a little bit more flexible with my schedule. And two, the pay. It was paying rather nicely. So for that reason, that's the reason I decided to take the load. Those that have been watching me, you know, typically I run locally. I run Monday through Friday, 8 to 4. Well, guess what? It's been slow. Like, I always get inboxes with people asking me, is it slow over here? How are things are over here? The tanker industry is slow. It's slow. Like, people keep wanting to jump lanes and come over to tankers. We're slow. Don't ask me why. Now, granted, I do know that there are some companies and there are some individuals who are still rolling. Even with Henna, I know one specific driver who has never slowed down. He's never skipped a beat. Everybody been out here kind of up and down, and he has been steady. However, that's his lane. You get what I'm saying? That's something that he is secured with. But anyway, so just to give you an example of what I mean by slow, myself along with a large number of other drivers just ran the load that I was on. We went to Texas, to Houston, and I knew that I was coming back today on a fresh clock, so I let dispatch know, like, hey, I can't work this weekend because I'm going out of town, but if you have something for Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, let me know. I can run that. As long as I'm back Friday evening, Friday night, I'm good. Well, I was told we don't have anything. Well, let me take that back. They did have something, but it was definitely something that I was not going to take. So they already kind of know what I'm willing to do, what I'm not willing to do. So they had something, but it wasn't stuff that I was willing to take. Maybe something may pop up between now and Friday. I don't know if it does. Amen to that. But if not, it just is what it is. However, I asked my terminal manager. I said, hey, I'm going into Texas. I know that I don't typically do this, but do you think that you can find me something coming out of Texas, coming back this way? Or if I would have had to take it to like South Carolina, Mississippi, Alabama, Florida, anywhere coming this way, can you find me something? And he straight up said, look, they've already informed everybody that all of our drivers have to return to their home terminals. There is no freight coming up out of Texas for, because they have a large amount of drivers going directly to this one location, and everybody just had to return to their home terminals. Now, for me, it wasn't that big of a deal because I'm right here. I was only 5 hours away from my terminal. However, I was sitting with somebody who literally his terminal was in like Wilmington, North Carolina or something. So he had a deadhead all the way from Houston all the way back up there, and I was just like, ooh, that's kind of, yeah. But that just gives you an idea of how it's been. So stuff has been picking back up. It's still not full swing how it was, but hey, it just brings out the hustlers. Because prime example on Tanker Yankers, people like, oh, y'all keep trying to make it seem like blah, 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 blah. You have to have something other than trucking going on. Period. If you sitting up here just waiting on one bag and you going more and more in the hole waiting on one bag, then that's on you. It's slow everywhere. There's no one company that's just slow. There's no one individual just slow. Yes, it's slow everywhere. However, I have been able to maintain. I have no complaints. Like I said, that load, really, it was worth it for me to take it. Would I do it again? I would have to think about it for a second before I would just say yes to it. Honestly, it would depend on the times. It would depend on the weather, because honestly, I feel like that's what's wrong with my truck. That rain, that weather. Big Mama is sensitive. She's electronical. And I drove through 2 days, 2 full days worth of driving, straight nothing but rain, nothing but rain. Even when I stopped, nothing but rain. So I'm pretty sure that that's what's wrong with my truck. What else do I have to say? Am I leaving? No, obviously I'm not leaving. I'm here. Do I have any regrets on getting my truck? No, I don't have any regrets on getting my truck. I know some people be feeling like, oh, I know she not still doing this, she not still doing that. Yes, I'm still here. Yes, I'm still doing this because I love what I do. And yeah, so that's the update. Hopefully I answered the questions that y'all have been sending to me. And again, I truly appreciate y'all staying and lasting through this vlog, because it was a week long vlog. I don't even know how long this is going to be, but I'm gonna put it all together and I'm gonna get it out as soon as I can, you know. But I am gonna try to get back on top of my content. I don't know how I'm gonna do with it, but anyways, y'all, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the likes, the shares, the comments, the subscriptions. Thank you for following me on Facebook, IG, Snapchat, TikTok, all of those great places. As always, I'm the beauty who's pushing this beast, and I'm out.